today of Ted Guastello. He's the Vice President of Operations from Newport Academy, and you are more than certified to talk to us about what parents should know about their teens and their mental health. There's Ted. Look at that nice photo with the crest on the jacket.
You definitely look the same in person. Nice photo.
Thank you.
That is a great picture of you.
Did you just take that outside?
Yeah.
Consistency is something I really strive for. So thank you both for bringing attention to this. I know that there are a lot of parents out there that September kind of crept up on. And I'm glad we're going to be able to talk about some things that will bring attention to things that might be going on in their home.
I also think as parents, they might not have had this as an issue as children, so they don't know how to deal with it with their new kids who are going to be teenagers, because it wasn't something their parents talked to them about. How do you kind of bridge that gap to make parents know that it's important?
Absolutely. I mean, we are actually seeing a significant increase in the amount of teens struggling with generalized anxiety disorder. Mm-hmm. So it's substantially increased over surveys taken in the 80s or 90s. Now, some of that may be access to help, but I also think it's a scarier, more challenging world people are being placed in, whether it's social media or also just the pressures to perform. I think we know now more than ever how important it is to have a competitive transcript, right?
Mm-hmm. Technology definitely wasn't something our parents were being talked about and going over with our grandparents because it didn't exist. So how is technology impacting anxiety for teens these days?
Absolutely. There's just no unplugging anymore. Mm-hmm. And so whether it's the fear of missing out and teens seeing all their friends mm-hmm. on social media living their best life, or whether it's, you know, Fortnite all into the night, it takes a toll. So it takes a toll both on self-image. It also takes a toll just sleep deprivation. And then the last thing I would say is there's a response system that actually happens in the brain where we can be reliant on social media or games for positive stimuli, right? So mm-hmm. when you get a like, there's a actual chemical reaction that happens in your brain that makes you feel good. Like a lot of chemical reactions that make you feel good, it can lead you to some pretty bad places.
What happens though when you're speaking to parents, and like Samantha said, they didn't kind of grow up with that. Do you notice a learning curve for parents as well, that these sort of things are real and these effects do actually happen? Do they kind of agree right away that that's going on?
Oh, 100%. So what I often see is parents know something is going on. They know that their kid's not interested in soccer anymore and they used to want to play in the World Cup. They know that their kid's friend group changed or they're even more monosyllabic than usual, mm-hmm. right? But what parents sometimes have a hard time putting a face on is what actually is happening. So mm-hmm. what's Instagram? What's Snapchat? I hear a lot from parents that once they catch up to something, the kids are on to the new one, right? And so we've actually had a lot of fun at Newport Academy working with our parents to really educate them around the issues. There's, you know, one thing that comes to mind is mandatory is teaching parents what a Finsta is, right? Mm. So a fake Instagram account that a teenager may have where they're living a completely different life
right.
than what you're seeing sitting across from you at the table. We've even, in some of the communities we serve, we've done a mock bedroom. So we will do a teenager's bedroom and we'll show the parents, hey, this thing you think is a USB hard drive, it's actually a discrete marijuana delivery device. It's for vaping, right?
Yeah.
And so it is a challenging world. Parents need to be empowered.
So how do you tell parents what to look for in their children? Because teens already sleep a lot. They want to go home and sleep, mm-hmm. but how do you know between depression or overworked, or what do you tell parents?
Yeah, I mean, adolescence is such an awesome but challenging age anyway, right? Mm-hmm. So how can you tell if your teenager is exhibiting typical teenage behavior or maybe is starting to show us something a little more serious? So a quarter of all teens will actually struggle with generalized anxiety disorder at some point in their life. That means that they're not able to participate fully in their lives because of a mental health issue. So parents can look for their children isolating, their children losing interest in things that they were formerly passionate about, decreased school performance, decreased eye contact, decreased communication, and then changing peer group, changes in weight, either gain or loss, changes in their relationship with food. all of these things are warning signs. And one thing we at Newport Academy are striving to do is to support the communities that we're a part of. And so as part of back to school season, we are ushering in free face-to-face assessments with mental health professionals for California families. All they have to do is call 877-NA-TEENS, and they'll be connected with a member of our team, and we'll set up a no-cost, no-obligation face-to-face assessment for their teenager to help determine, is this just the state of being a teenager, or could this be something more serious?
And what you say on the website was that you're not trying to make a pitch or anything. You're just trying to help the community. It's not like a sales pitch to get somebody to sign up at Newport Academy. You honestly just want to help the communities you're in.
100%. I see the biggest struggle that I see is the number of families that are struggling with some undiagnosed mental health issue in their household, and they feel like help is a million miles away. If you're an individual whose teenager is not getting out of bed, if they're quitting activities that they used to be passionate about, if they've just lost their joy in life, please get help. Please. That's what we're here for.
And what is the Newport Academy for those who don't know?
Yeah, Newport Academy is a truly revolutionary program. We take a compassionate approach to healing teenagers and their families who may be struggling with mental health issues, whether it's depression, anxiety. And because we're working with teenagers, we try to take a fun approach. I had the great pleasure of spending a day as a client on Tuesday, and I got to do music therapy. I did a life skills group where me and six boys actually sat in silence and meditated. We're a really mindful program that combines physical engagement, mental engagement, emotional awareness, and family therapy.
What do you do to remove that stigma, though, that, you know, kids are embarrassed, I'm going to get treatment, or I'm going, you know, how do you get past that so they want to come and understand its importance?
That's one of the hardest things that I see today. I don't know a single person whose family hasn't been impacted by depression, anxiety, substance abuse, and yet the number of people getting help is very low. I think one thing people can do is be open, be authentic, take every opportunity to share about their journey. And then also we try to make a therapeutically informed lifestyle something people can be proud of.
Right.
That's what this bad boy is all about.
Yes. And if we want to just throw up that full screen one more time with the phone number on it so people can reach out. Anything else you want to get out there before we run up against the clock here, Ted?
No, not at all. I mean, the last thing that I always like to say is that the best way parents can help their teens is by taking care of themselves, right? Anyone who's ever flown knows that they want to put their own mask on before assisting others.
Smart.
So parents, don't be afraid to start a mindfulness practice of your own. It's amazing how 2 minutes of meditation a couple times a day can change your outlook.
And where can we go to find more?
NewportAcademy.com.
Thank you so much. Do have resources there, like meditations that people can start doing.
True. There's so much stuff. My apologies if you fall down a wormhole of interesting stuff.
True. Free YouTube meditation videos. All I'm saying, I found them on the website.
They're great.
They're great.
They're great.
Thank you so much for being here. We'll be back on 5 Live.